In this lecture of transformer, we are going to discuss about transformer windings. According to the previous lecture, principal components of a transformer were classified as magnetic circuit, electric circuit, and the tank. Electric circuit of the transformer is mainly comprised of windings, insulation, and bushings. Transformer windings includes different rounds of copper coil bundles where every bundle is connected to form a winding. Windings are mainly depend on the input-output supply, otherwise on the range of voltage. The transformer winding diagram is given below. The transformer winding is made of several turns of copper coil bundles. Each of the coil bundle is joined to create a winding. Input-output supply voltage and the range of voltages are the two key factors that affects the winding. Generally, in the transformer, we will define the primary side of the transformer as the side that usually takes power and the secondary as the side that usually delivers power. In a single phase voltage transformer, the primary side is usually the side with the higher voltages. These two coils are wrapped around a single closed magnetic iron circuit known as the core, rather than being in electric contact with one another. To reduce the core's magnetic loss, this soft iron core is not composed of a single piece of material but rather than consists several interconnected laminations. The common core connects the primary and the secondary windings magnetically, allowing electrical power to flow from one coil to the another even if they are electrically disconnected from one another. When an electric current flows through the primary winding, a magnetic flux is created that induces a voltage into the secondary winding. The transformer windings are the most important parts of a transformer. There are different types of transformer windings that are available on the market. The transformer windings are chosen depending on many parameters such as voltage, current, and capacity of the transformer under construction. Let us see some of the requirements for the transformer winding. The selected transformer winding must comply with a number of requirements. Here are a few of the most important. Windings should be cost-effective, both in terms of initial cost and market availability of copper, as well as in terms of transformer's efficiency. Temperature specification for transformer's winding must be met, since deviation from these values significantly reduces the transformer's service life. Transformer's windings need to be mechanically stable with regard to the forces brought on by unexpected short circuits. The winding's electrical strength should be sufficient to tolerate overvoltages. These criteria often run counter to one another. For instance, a higher current density in the winding results in less copper being used, which causes copper loss or I2R losses to rise and the efficiency of the transformer drops. Allowing a greater temperature rise in the winding results in a smaller transformer, but a shorter service life. As a result, it is crucial to carefully plan the winding of a modern transformer, particularly when it comes to high voltage transformers. Let us see some advantage for the transformer's winding. With the transformer winding, high conduct flux leakage and the iron loss can be avoided. The mechanical strength of these windings is high. It is very efficient while working with higher frequency. They have less failure rate and the production cost is very low. Some of the disadvantages of the transformer winding can be listed as following. These windings are very hard to twist. Accuracy is less in positioning the coils, so electrical characteristics and the performance can be changed. Higher expenses are given on manual lever. Applications of the transformer's winding. Transformer's winding come in two varieties, primary and secondary. Primary transformer windings takes energy from the primary source, while the secondary transformer's windings transport energy to the load. In AC circuit, it increases or decreases the capacitor value or resistance or an inductor. The transformer windings can increase or decrease the voltage or current level. Let us see what are the materials that are used for the construction of the transformer's winding. Transformer winding materials are aluminium and copper, which are the most frequently used conductors in the transformer's winding. The mechanical strength and the conductivity are high for the copper, whereas the aluminium materials are less cost, lightweight as compared to copper. Generally, the copper windings are used in the large transformers, whereas aluminium conductors are used for small size and medium size transformers. Aluminium conductors must have a greater cross-section in order to carry current with similar performance as copper conductors. Copper conductor is heavier than aluminium, which is also more costly, or aluminium is both lighter and less expensive than copper conductors. Copper conductors are often used exclusively because of their superior mechanical strength, with the exception of lower size ranges where aluminium conductors might be appropriate. In cases where extreme forces are encountered, materials such as silver-bearing copper can be used for even greater strength. Now, let us understand how we position higher voltage and lower voltage windings in the transformer. In terms of insulation requirement, the position of higher voltage HV and LV windings with respect to the core is very critical. It would be essential to insulate the HV winding from both the core and the LV winding if it were located near to the core. Furthermore, two layers of high voltage insulation would be necessary. When the high voltage winding is placed outside and around the low voltage winding, only one layer of high voltage insulation is necessary. It is possible to arrange high and low voltage windings in a concentric or sandwich arrangement. That's why transformer windings may be classified into two groups, concentric winding and sandwich winding. Concentric windings are used in the core type transformer and sandwich windings are most exclusively used in the shell type transformers. The positioning of HV and LV windings with respect to the core is very important from the point of view of insulation requirements. The vertical sections of the magnetic core, which are also known as limbs, hold the windings in the place, and the horizontal sections of the top and bottom of the magnetic core are known as yokes. The low voltage winding is placed nearer to the core in the case of concentric windings, and in the case of sandwich windings, it is placed on the outside position. Each windings in the concentric arrangement has a common center, forming circles in each cross section. In sandwich windings, the high voltage and low voltage windings alternate along the leg height. Because of easier insulation, concentric winding places low voltage winding closer to the core, while sandwich winding places it on the outside. The insulation spaces between low and high voltage coils also serve to facilitate cooling. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.